right, folks. I'm going to do something I haven't done in quite a few years, I think. At least it seems that way anyway, since I did one. And that's a mail call video. I don't usually do them because I don't get a lot of things that are like this anyway in the mail. And when I do get something that's kind of interesting in the mail, it was kind of premeditated and ends up being kind of like a product review or a kit review or something like that. This is different. This was a surprise. I didn't know about this at all. Well, that's not true. This kit I did, these ones I didn't. So I got two surprises on my doorstep today. One was a kit that I ordered back in March from an eBay seller called Peaceful 2018, who I buy from semi-regularly. Pretty good dude or dudette, I'm not really sure. I was somewhat worried that the package had gotten lost because the tracking kind of stopped as soon as it got on the airplane in China, and then that was it. There was nothing. And then it just showed up out of the blue weeks and weeks later. I was a little worried, but I'm very happy to see that that was not the case. It just showed up and ta-da. So I'm very happy. The other was a complete surprise, and both of them arrived at the same time. So a fellow named Martin Colmer, who every now and again he just boxes up a bunch of weird things and strange things and wonderful things and sends them my way. He lives down in the U.S. and he has a very kind and generous spirit, apparently, because he keeps doing this. I do not know if he does this for other people. I don't know. I have not seen evidence of that, but if I am the sole recipient of his generosity, Martin, you have my deepest thanks. He sent me a few kits over the years, and every single one of them has been something sort of special. The most recent one from these was a First World War battleship, German battleship, in 350 scale, which I haven't built yet. I managed to get some aftermarket barrels and some photo etch and some railings for it and everything. But I'm hunting around for a wooden deck. And just when I found one and I ordered it on eBay, the pandemic hit. And I ended up having to cancel the order because it wouldn't ship. So I told myself as soon as things settle down, I'll try again and order it. I just haven't gotten around to doing it yet. So it was actually on the docket to be built last year, but it just never ended up working out. It's still very much high on my priority list because I really like working in 350 scale for ships like that. It seems to be my comfort zone since I'm a novice at ships. Having a comfort zone is nice. So anyway, Martin this time sent me these. It's kind of funny because this kit, strangely enough, just a couple of days ago I was on Amazon in Canada because it's the only place I can really shop anymore. And I was looking at this kit and it was a bit overpriced on Amazon, but it usually is. And I don't usually buy them unless I really, really want the kit. I know I'm not going to get it anywhere else anytime soon. I was looking at this and I was thinking, I haven't built a Stug in a long time and I kind of really like the early ones, the A, B, and C. I've always, I seem to be attracted to Panzer Grey, I guess. But either way, this one was on my radar because it comes with photo etch and it comes with a metal barrel, which is really weird. So this is kind of a unicorn Stugmaschutz. Stug. I've never been able to pronounce that. German is something I've always wanted to be able to speak, but my mouth says, you know what, fuck you, you speak English, and that's it. And badly, too. I speak it with an East Coast Canadian accent. Eh? So, take my dog for a walk, eh? So, that's the East Coast Canadian accent. Holy fuck, I'm taking the dog for a walk. So, the Stug 3 is, next to Shermans and Tigers, the Stug has always been something I've always had a thing for. I kind of like them. Kind of like the Panzer 3 too, but that's Hamilcar's thing. he can have that. So, but I like Stokes. So anyway, so I was looking at this, and I was kind of tempted to buy it and then detail it up, because I have some photo etched supersets up here above my thing here that I could, you know, dazzle this thing up a bit. And I got new glasses now, and I have my super duper geek glasses now. These are my super duper geek glasses. My daughter won't talk to me when I'm giving her shit if I'm wearing these. She tells me to take them off because she can't take me seriously. They're super huge and like super duper geeky, but they're just for modeling, and they're great for doing PE and stuff, so they make me very happy. And the glasses that I normally wear, they're progressives, or what some people call bifocals, but not actually bifocals, but same sort of idea. They also, you know, work for doing photo etch and stuff like that. So I have a slight return to being able to do detail work for a little while anyway, until I go blind again. So for the next little while, I can fiddle with some detail. So I was tempted to get this kit and do it up. Lo and behold, Martin sends it to me, even though I haven't talked to Martin in a while. Every time he sends me something, I always try to thank him by sending him an email or sending him a message through YouTube, which YouTube has decided we don't need to talk to each other anymore, or commenting on one of his comments or something. But I've never been actually able to get a hold of him. So I've thanked him in videos and stuff and everything. So I'm thanking him again and again and again and again. But so this one here is kind of a special one, because I was actually planning on doing something with this very kit. Poof, here it is. So this is cool. This was a very interesting surprise. I wasn't expecting that. It was pretty cool. Now, these ones were extra interesting. There's two of them. An Imperial kit, Dragon, and the new Smart kit. The same thing. Same subject. It's like a Brumbar sort of idea. I can't pronounce the name, and I'm not going to try. Storm Infantry Shooter Gun. Shoot, gun, assault. I don't know. I guess it depends on your mood how you want to say that. I'm not German, so I don't know. So either way, it's an infantry support tank. Bunker buster. Building knocker downer. It's something similar to the Brumbar. With a big fuck-off gun. Really big fuck-off gun. So it's been something I have been wanting to build for some time, but I've never built this kit. I've never built this subject either, so I have no familiarity with this thing other than the lower hull. I've built many of these, but this whole superstructure thing is all new to me. And it's a Dragon kit, so it'll be very interesting. This one comes with the DS tracks, the Dragon styrene tracks. The other one comes with the old-fashioned individual link tracks that are on the sprue, which I don't much care for. I prefer the magic tracks, but Dragon doesn't do them anymore. I will happily do the DS tracks, though. I don't like the individual links on a sprue. I hate that. I'll take the Dragon styrene any day. I can work with them so much easier. I can do the sag really easy, and I can paint them easy without the paint coming off and all that stuff and everything, because I just do it all as one single sub-assembly, and it's easy peasy. I've done a video on that, so it's somewhere in my how-to list. So now these two kits, it's kind of funny. It's not something I've been thinking about recently, but it was something that I had planned, but I wasn't sure what subject I was going to do it with. But these gave me the idea that I could do it with these. I would only do it with one, because I have a plan for the other kit. There's a diorama built by Shepard Payne a long, long time ago that has always been somewhat of an inspiration for me. And I'm showing you pictures of it now. And it's a Brumbar, but the idea of it has inspired another build of mine, my Stugenhole. But I've always wanted to do something that was more reminiscent of what Shep was doing with the vehicle shape and type, but I didn't want to use a Brumbar. And I've built a few Brumbars, and I don't find them to be a very exciting kit. Well, that's not true. Not an exciting machine. The kits are interesting, but the machines aren't very interesting. This thing here is pretty homemade looking. So by homemade, I mean they slapped it together. It's, you know, they made it up as they were going along, sort of idea. Germans didn't really do that. They're pretty clever folk, but they did one of their, you know, take this vehicle and weld it to that vehicle kind of thing and make it go. That kind of magic that they were good at. So that kind of speaks to me. So I would kind of, and there's another fellow, Brighton Paul, he's building this really wonky, cool thing. It's similar to this. And I think it's even the same size gun that's in it. But they literally took an artillery piece with like wagon wheels, literally, like it had wagon wheels, and they put it on top of a Panzer IV chassis and then built sidewalls around it. This is similar to that, but it has a roof and a back wall. So and it's all kind of inspiration, all rolling together, and I kind of like that idea. So anyway, I want to use this kit in that Shepard Payne-inspired type idea, and see how close I can get it to like a Shepard Payne type feel. Because he's always been a giant source of inspiration for me, and I've learned so much from what he's done, and I've taken what he's done and tried to expand it into what I do, and he's just been a huge contributor to the hobby for me, so why not, right? So the other kit, the Imperial kit, I'm probably going to take it with, or put it with another kit that I have. Another fella named Nick, and Nick knows who he is, he almost regularly sends me just weird packages. I never know what to expect whenever I get a package from Nick, because anything can come out of it. I could open it and there could be a big pile of kits and figures and photo etch and weird looking resin things and stuff, or I could open it and a Smurf could run out and give me kisses and then run off and marry my dog. I mean, I never know. He sends me strange things, very strange things, and I love it because I never know what to expect. And it's like weird Christmas garland and candy canes and weird stuffed animals and stuff from antiquated, like ancient British television shows and stuff that my kids would never get, but they like them anyway. This is really cool. And I don't know where he finds most of this stuff. I wish I knew, but I don't know where he finds most of this stuff, but wherever it is, it's awesome because my kids just think it's all cool and strange and weird. They never know what to expect. And so anyway, he sent me, he sent me a couple of them, but it's the rail beds, the rail cars that they used to transport these things around with. And I've always wanted to do train yard or rail yard type of diorama. You know, a couple of big modelers have done that kind of thing. And I wanted to see if I could kind of do one. It's a really big deal, and I want to see if I can do one. It's going to be a little while before I get to that because I have some big things that are coming up. Changes to my house. I'm going to be renovating, and I'm going to be moving my cave to another part of the house. And my cave is getting almost a 45 to 50% increase in space. Excuse me. So I will have more display space on the walls. I'll have a bigger bench, it'll be more organized, it'll have better light because it has two great big windows in it, I won't be in the basement, so it won't be quite as cool during the summer, but I'll be upstairs and closer to my garage too, so it's easier for me to go and work in the garage if I have to, if I need diorama stuff. As it is now, I have to truck to the other end of the house in order to do any work, but either way, that's down the road. We're waiting for prices to drop on materials and stuff, as like everybody is, because prices are so high at the moment. So, but with that expansion in space means I can maybe build a couple more dioramas that are somewhat bigger and not have to throw them away right away because I have a substantially larger area to display them. So, it could be exciting. It's going to be a while, though. So I was very excited to see these kits. They gave me lots of inspiration, lots of ideas. Some I didn't even know I was going to do. One I knew I was going to do, and that was really cool. So that was like, it was like he was reading my mind. It was very cool. So Martin, if you're watching this, I hugely appreciate these. they're definitely going to get used. I've got big plans for these, so I'm hoping that you'll see them come into existence sooner rather than later. So the other thing that I got, this came as kind of a surprise because I thought it actually got lost in the mail. So this I ordered back in March from I mentioned it before, Peaceful 2018. It's an eBay seller. I thought it disappeared from the universe, but it just magically showed up out of nowhere. And so I don't have to ask for my money. I always hate when packages go missing and I have to ask for my money back and all that, because half the time, I mean, I don't know if Peaceful 2018 would do it. I can't predict that kind of thing. Sometimes they block you after you've asked your money back because something went missing. I've had it happen a bunch of times where eBay sellers that I regularly buy from just block me because the package went missing and I had to get a refund. It's annoying that they are allowed to do that, but I understand why they would be allowed to block people. But I think that eBay should have some restrictions on why they're blocking people. They have to have specific reasons why they're doing it. Just arbitrarily, it seems somewhat unprofessional and very bad for business and bad for eBay's business. And I don't have to risk asking for my money back. I always hate asking for, and sometimes I don't get my money back anyway. That 100% buyer protection thing isn't 100%, I've discovered. Just because something goes missing in your mail doesn't mean you're going to get your money back, I've discovered, even if you use PayPal. There's been a bunch of times I haven't got my money back. So this I ordered back in March, like I said. I've built the late version of this kit, and I thought it was a wonderful kit. It was so easy to build, great fits. It had the really cool styrene Zimrit that you just glue on and can damage to your heart's content. It was an incredibly fun kit. The only downside, and I haven't opened this yet to look, but the only downside was the tracks. The tracks that come with the late production kit were completely useless. You could not use them because they had no lightning holes in the guide teeth. The guide teeth were solid. There are no tiger tracks with solid guide teeth. They don't exist. So I couldn't use them. I had to dig in my stash and pull something else out. I'm trying to remember now if I actually used them anyway. I don't remember. I know I bought the kit twice, and on the second one I used them. It was on my Tiger 312 when I built that photograph. I can't remember if I did it on the initial build or not when I did the build review. Either way, it doesn't matter. But I'm looking at the painting that they have on here. Vincent Way did it in 2017, and he didn't put the lightning holes in the guide teeth. So that tells me that the kit probably doesn't have them either. Oh, look at that, they're right on top. Yeah. Nope, no lightning holes. So these tracks are useless as well. So I have to try and find somewhere in my stash here of Tiger bits and pieces. If I have any late model Tiger tracks that have lightning holes in them, I might. I don't know. I may have used them all up. I have some AFE Club ones. Yep, I can have some there. They're unfortunate. They're AFE Club, and I hate AFE Club's Tiger tracks. I have... Nope, those are useless. I have some... Yes, these... Oh, these don't have guide teeth. Oh, I know what these are from. These are dragon. Yeah. I don't know if I want to build those. And these are magic tracks. These don't have the guide teeth. Not all of them, anyway. Oh, some of them do. Some of them are hollow. Yeah, okay. No, I've got magic tracks that I can use. And I have a single, no, those are early, those are no good. Those are early, early. AFE club. Not, there's pro model, but there's not enough of them. Those are early, those are early. These are mid. There's not enough of them. All right, so I have enough Dragon Magic Track ones that I can use. So I can replace the tracks on here, so that's not a problem. So anyway, my plan, and it's going to be a recent thing, and it'll be happening on, I can't say when, but it'll be soon in the sequence of events. This is going to be built into Otokaris's Tiger 217. Now, I originally built 217 10 years ago. Yeah, it was 10 years ago. And when I was doing the research back then, it was back when I first started doing builds from photos, and I made the mistake of thinking that the one that I was building was Otokaris's Tiger, when it actually wasn't. It was it was 217, and eventually it would become Otto's, but it wasn't at the time. It was the fellow who commanded it before Otto, because it still had the white winter camouflage. When Otto became the commander of 217, it had no winter camouflage on it, so it was just in the standard camouflage colors. So that was a mistake I had made, and I made some other mistakes on the build too, accuracy wise, and I wasn't happy with it. I still have it somewhere. I want to rebuild it. I want to rebuild all of Otto's tanks, because over the time I've built all of them. But I want to rebuild them because my skills have advanced, and I built them years and years and years ago, and I want to rebuild them, revisit them. But finding the kits is sometimes hard. Finding a Tiger, a medium, mid-production Tiger, I don't know why they said medium production, it's a mid-production Tiger, with Zimmerit, that's not going to cost you $2 or $3 million, is not an easy thing to do. So I was happy to get this. I want to get his 38T and his early Tiger, which I'm probably going to get one of the Ryfield ones to do that. I have enough spare parts here that I can mess around with it to make it accurate. And then his Yag Tiger. Don't know. I have built his Yag Tiger, but I don't know if I'm going to build a new kit or just use the one that I have. Yag Tiger kits are hard to find and kind of expensive, so that one might be on hold for a while. So anyway, that's the grand plan. Now, I didn't actually look at the parts of this thing. I just looked at the tracks, and like I said, these are no good. And typical of the last one, everything's all wrapped in foam and plastic bags, just like the other one was. And the only thing I really want to look at, because I'm assuming that everything looks the same as the other kit. And the other kit was superb. Oh, wow, look at that texture. Too bad it'll all be covered. They should do an early. If they do an early production, I don't know if they have. I don't think they have. If Trumpeter has done an early production, this texturing would be very nice on an early. Because all the mids and lates, look at Zimmerit on them, you can't see this lovely texturing that they put on there. Yeah, okay. First glance, everything is meh. It's okay. I can't tell about the sprockets. I have to check the alignment of the bolts. And this is the really cool, awesome Zimmerit that's on a sheet. You can just lay it on and glue it. It's wonderful stuff. But this stuff is wicked cool. I'm not seeing any photo etch. Turret. Just grills. Well, that's something. At least it's not like Tammy where they can't bother to give you grills. Well, that's okay. The only photo that you really need for this kit is for the grills. Everything else you can do with styrene. Yeah. Interesting. I'll have to get new markings. Can't use those for what I want to use. But essentially, this looks like the same as the late model kit, just with the modifications to upgrade it. It's too bad they didn't fix these tracks. They really should get someone to point that out to them. I'm sure they probably know. They just don't care enough to do anything about it. Molding hollow guide teeth is difficult, and I think probably expensive, which is why they are not doing it and why Tamiya never did it. Yeah, but either way, I can fix it. So I guess kind of an impromptu, very summarized kit review. a weird video, I guess. I haven't done one like these for a while, kind of a shoot the shit sort of thing. So same sort of kind of video I do on my archery video or YouTube channel. I just shoot the shit. Again, Martin, thank you very much for these. And Nick, thank you for the things that I'm going to be including with these too, and because Nick sent me stuff there a while ago. This one here is going to be interesting to do too. So it's a good day. Good day at the office. Anyway, you guys be good. Keep your stick on the ice. Bye for now.